What's up, basketball fans? Welcome back to Trash Talk. Back with me, Rocky Padilla, and today I have Coach James Clark. How you doing, Coach?
Hey, what's up, baby? Good to see you, man.
Always good to see you, too. Yeah. To remind everybody, Coach James Clark was with CLS Nas Indonesia as a team consultant. So we're going to talk about CLS first, a little bit.
Let's talk about it.
So you were there to help the players to improve their skills.
Yeah.
What do you think of their potential of mostly of the, I mean, about the young players?
The locals? Well, yeah, local young players. I mean, CLS got some good, Indonesia got some good local players. You know, everybody there works hard, you know, and I think with what Coco's trying to do with them is get the player development side up and running. I know they just started recently practicing early. Matter of fact, Coco texted me this morning, asked me how I'm doing out here. But, you know, I think, you know, everybody on that team, you know, has room to improve. And I think they're making the right strides to get there, you know.
And then we know that CLS struggled during the ABL season.
Yeah.
What do you think do they need to improve on to get better next season?
I think the locals really got to come back with a little bit more scoring. You know, I think last year we relied so much on the imports, you know, with Brian and then Shane came in, you know, and that, you know, Mario had to thrust into more scoring that he probably might not have wanted to at that at the point in his career. Freddie came on a little late towards the end, but I think if we could get, you know, between 15, 20 points from the locals, that'll be big for what CLS can do for next year in the ABL.
So you actually came to CLS because of your friend, Coach Phil Handy.
Yeah.
So can you tell us a little bit how you and Coach Phil Handy know each other?
Man, so me and Coach Phil, we met when we was 18 years old. He was 19. I was a young 18.
Okay.
And
was this though?
This is the Bay Area. So we're both Bay Area kids.
San Francisco.
San Francisco, man. He grew up on the east side. I grew up on the Bay Area side. Okay. He grew up in like Hayward area. But you know, if y'all would have seen that guy play basketball, man. Now there's somebody who likes to talk trash. Yeah, I said it first. That gray-haired beard dude right there, who be giving all the handles and stuff, talks trash daily. Right? But nah, man. So we grew up. We played junior college against each other. And you know, one thing about me and everybody knows me, man. People respect me because I play defense, and two, I'm a competitor.
Okay.
And you know, if people at CLS in Surabaya, y'all know I like to compete. I don't like to lose, as you know, clearly we saw by some of my antics after games. But
we won't talk about that.
But nah, man, it was good, and we go way back, man. So you know, Phil has been my mentor, my brother, and he's somebody I respect and love at all at the same time, man.
So. Let's talk about you a little bit.
Huh? Yeah, talk about it. What's up?
What's keeping you busy these days?
Man, we just got done with pre-draft workouts.
Okay.
You know, I was working with a guy named Robert Williams. He went to Texas A&M. Just got picked up by the Boston Celtics at the 27th pick, I believe, of the first round. It's been a whirlwind, you know. Before that, I was working with a guy named Reed Travis from Stanford University, which I love Reed to death. Reed took his name out of the draft. You know, he was an underclassman, and then finished his degree at Stanford. Now he's at University of Kentucky.
Wow.
So, and I'm telling you, all you people in Lexington, man, y'all gonna love BBN. Y'all gonna love Reed Travis. I tell you that right now. So, yeah, I've been busy, man. I've been running.
So, what was your reaction, though, when you found out about Ralph getting drafted by the Celtics?
Well, you know, his whole thing, you know, we expected him to go a little higher.
Okay.
You know, Rob was a potential top 15 pick, and you know, we did a lot of work with the Clippers, and you know, I did on the Robert Williams tour. We went to Denver, we went to Chicago, we went to Charlotte, New York, all those teams that were picking somewhere between 7 through 15. Okay. We kind of figured that's where he's going to fall to. But if you're going to go down in the draft, nothing wrong with the Boston Celtics, you know, the team of the East right now, between them and Philadelphia. But I love Coach Brad Stevens, man. He's a great coach, man. He's a great guy. Opened his door up, and Danny Ainge. I met Danny Ainge. I used to hate the Celtics, man. And the first person who picks me up is Danny Ainge, you know? So it was awesome, man. It was a great feeling. So,
I saw you though.
Yeah.
You were at the Boston Celtics facility.
Man, it's beautiful, man.
It's new, right?
Yeah, it's brand new. It's right off the freeway. Mm-hmm. It's the first thing you walk in is you see all the banners.
Man, you see that banner, right?
You get a little feeling inside you, right? So I saw the banners and I was like, wow, man, I'm in Boston. First of all, then I'm in the Celtics practice facility, state of the art, two beautiful brand new courts. New whirlpool, that little floating thing that Steph Curry lives on, man. But nah, man, it's beautiful, man. I couldn't be more happy for the kid. He's in a great situation where he can actually almost play, get some playing time.
I think he will get some playing
time. I hope so. You know, but, I'm working with him.
Yeah, but it's crazy, man. Yeah. I mean, like, they still got Kyrie didn't play. Gordon was out the whole season.
You know?
So can you imagine how good they're going to be?
Hey, you know, as a coach, and Coach Steve's second year in a row getting his team to the Eastern Conference Finals, right? And he did it with, you know, Terry Rozier, Scary Terry, who had an unbelievable playoff series, whole playoffs. And then, you know, you always got the constant in and Al Horford, you know, the captain, so to speak. And then Jaylen Brown, man, your boy, right? JB coming to Indonesia, y'all be ready, man. JB coming out there.
JB coming out at the end of the month.
That's right, man. So, but having him out there,
like, I can't forget Jason Tatum.
I can't forget Tatum, man. JT's. And I gotta give props out to a guy named Drew Hanlon, man, who's been working with all these guys out there in LA. I know you got a chance to sit down with him as another player development coach. You kind of respect what other guys are doing, but yo, Drew, man, if you ever see this, man, you're doing a hell of a job, bro, man. I respect you 100, and you know, holler at me when you can one day, all right, homeboy. But getting back to Jason Tatum, that boy is nice, man.
I think he might be the top 10 player next season.
Right. Between him and your boy Spidey. Ben Spider-Man over there and my guy Ben Simmons, it was a toss-up.
Yeah.
I actually thought they were going to get they both should have got Rookie of the Year, I thought. You know, I love Ben.
Cole Rookie.
I mean, they've done it before in the past, but, you know, because...
Donovan was king, but you
could have actually made a point for JC for Jason. You know, Jason could have, the way he did in the playoffs.
Man.
But he progressed the whole season. But man,
that dunk on LeBron.
Watch out, overhead. You gotta watch out, man.
Yeah.
Man, but yo, another guy. But like you're right, man. Kyrie, Gordon, Horford, Rozier back. Hopefully they re-sign Marcus Smart.
Hopefully,
you know. Then you got Tatum. Brown,
it's a squad.
The young fella might come in, the big Australian, just like to beat up on people, you know. So I mean, hey, the Celtics is
Aaron Baines.
He's just a beat out there. He came out there just bruises at that. That's all that Australian girth, you know. Yeah, knock you out. But man, I really enjoy the Celtics, man. Yeah.
So talking about Ben Simmons, you had a chance to work him out, and then you also work with DeJounte Murray from the Spurs.
Right.
What is it like to, you know, give training to those kind of players that kind of, how you say that? Man, my English is messing up.
It's all right. Say it in Indonesian.
I was saying it in Indonesian, but what is it like to train a player of that caliber?
Man, you know, it's an unbelievable experience. It's an unbelievable experience. You know, Ben, as I told when I first spoke with the Sixers and when I first met with Rich Paul, I said, he just got stuff that you just can't teach. You know, he's just a natural. He's a gifted passer. He's starting to, people don't be fooled now. I'm gonna say this on TV. You know, this is live. We're on live here. The boy can shoot. He doesn't like. He was a reluctant shooter with this team. I think he wanted to fill out. Mark my words. Ben Simmons will be shooting three balls this year. He's gonna be shooting some one dribble pull ups. You're gonna see a different Ben Simmons now. I'm not working with him. But I know the kid, I know he's got that thing right here, that heart, and he's gonna wanna prove naysayers wrong, because honestly, the league is gonna be his, you know.
He's a young kid.
He's a 6'10", light-skinned Magic Johnson, man, lefty too, bro, he's tough. And then DeJounte, man, he's just a killer. You know, props out, you know, baby boy, congratulations, man, on getting second team all-defensive player and all-defensive team. You know, the kid, man, you know, whatever happens with Kawhi, whatever it is, it's gonna be DeJounte and Kawhi's team and Kawhi stays, but it's basically Tony Parker getting traded, or not getting traded, but re-signing with the Charlotte. That's DeJounte's team, and I couldn't be more happier for that kid, man. He works.
He's gonna run the show.
Man, and he's gonna take off with it too. That kid lives in the gym. All you young fellas, man, you wanna be good, you gotta live in the gym. DeJounte Murray lives in the gym.
That's what everybody needs to do in Indonesia, for sure.
No question. And y'all got some hot gyms, man. I think I lost 10 pounds out there. for real, man. They had me playing pickups and that stuff, man. I was like, ooh, wait a minute. This gym is hot, bro.
Hold on, what did you
do? Yeah, I played pickup. Yeah, I played pickup at the CLS gym. Oh, man, I won. I almost busted my butt because it was raining earlier. And you know when it rains, that floor get a little slick.
Yeah, it is. Even during the ABL games.
Games, man.
Let's talk about the future.
Yeah.
What you got planned, man? What you got planned?
Man, that's... Can't really speak on that. Nah, I'm just kidding. Nah, I don't know yet, man. Honestly, just playing it by ear. You know, I'm with Robert right now, helping him transition to becoming a... not really say a boy to a man, so to speak, but, you know, helping him progress in his professional career his first year. I got a couple teams in the league that I'm talking to, hopefully.
Okay.
You know, hopefully try to, you know, see me out there pre-game, you know. You come out there, you know, I'll holler at you.
Oh,
you know,
of
give
course.
You some love, man.
Of
you
course.
Know?
But that's all for the interview, though, Coach.
Hey, man.
Appreciate it.
100, bro. Appreciate it.
Great catching up with you.
Sir, bye, man. First, before I leave, man, I also want to send my prayers out to those people that got affected by the bombings in Surabaya. You know, that's one of my, you know, hey, I lived there for 2.5 months. So, you know, that video was that stuff affected me too here. But, you know, hey, much respect to you guys. Thank you all my CLS Knights fans. My guy Rocky, talking trash, baby, right here. 100.
We didn't talk too much trash though today.
Not yet. We'll do that off camera.
Yeah, off camera. But, guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you guys next video. Peace.